Garcia is still processing the sudden death of her 29-year-old cousin, Efrain Lopez Garcia, a farm worker in Homestead, Florida. On July 6th, he died while working outdoors in the sweltering heat.
Well, unfortunately, he is not the only worker who has died due to hot temperatures and poor working conditions. In fact, a Kroger employee in Tennessee has just died as a result of extreme heat at the workplace that does not have air conditioning. Sounds like a bit of a problem, especially when we're talking about labor that requires you to, you know, be incredibly physical. And that was certainly the case for Tony Rufus, who worked in the salvage department of the grocery store, which again did not have air conditioning, or at least that area did not have air conditioning. He tried to cool himself off after getting overheated in the produce section of the store, but Memphis police ended up finding him dead at 8:13 p.m. Now, Teamsters 667 leader Maurice Wiggins told local media that guys said he was dripping with sweat asking for water. Wiggins said Rufus died on a dock in front of his coworkers. His death comes after his union had been asking the company for more breaks, cooler temperatures, and drinks other than just water. And if you're wondering what that means, likely, you know, fluids that have electrolytes and can help hydrate people a little quicker. Now, workers' unions across the country are in fact demanding better, cooler working conditions as heat waves rage on across the country. And as we know, every year seems to get hotter and hotter as a result of the climate emergency. It's very serious, but installing air conditioning cuts into profits. So of course, these companies are gonna fight against it. Now, when you look at companies like UPS, where their workers are unionized, they've got some leverage. And as a result of that leverage, they just secured an incredibly good contract, a new contract that ensures that their delivery drivers get to deliver packages in vehicles that are air conditioned. That's what happens when you have a seat at the table, when you have some leverage as a worker in an organized workplace. But unfortunately, workers' unions, or I should say, the percentage of employees protected by workers' unions is incredibly low in this country. And so those who do not have that leverage end up suffering the consequences of this system where companies want to maximize profits in an era where temperatures just get hotter and hotter every single year. Now, conservative political forces are pushing back against any effort to pass regulations ensuring that these workplaces have the proper breaks and work environment to keep people safe during these high temperatures. Lobbyists from the agriculture and construction industries, for instance, are working to prevent heat protection laws from going into effect at state and federal levels. And then the Biden administration has proposed some federal regulations requiring workers be protected from the heat, but no such law has materialized so far. And in September of 2021, the Biden administration announced the launch of a rulemaking effort at the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, also known as OSHA, of course, to develop heat exposure standards to protect outdoor and indoor workers. But there are pretty powerful lobbying groups representing various industries that again are fighting back against that rather aggressively. The American Farm Bureau Federation has objected to that proposal, for instance, considering the variances in agricultural work and climate, they argue. AFBF questions whether the department can develop additional heat illness regulations without imposing new onerous burdens on farmers and ranchers that will lead to economic losses. It's really not that difficult, right? Like, give people the proper breaks, ensure that they have adequate access to water. Like, these are not difficult things. It's not like the Biden administration proposed that like these agricultural workers be protected by a giant tent above the entire farm or something crazy like that. You know, but they don't want to spend a single dollar making the working conditions better for the workers, which is why, again, when you're dealing with a workplace, or if you're a farm worker and you're not unionized, you have to kind of rely on the whims of the government, either state, local government or federal government. And certainly in the case of the federal government, we're talking about significant legalized bribery being baked into the system, which leads to a lot of these lawmakers listening to moneyed interests as opposed to doing right by their constituents and these workers. Now, let's go to the state level, because this is what I found particularly disgusting while researching for this story. So in Texas, Governor Greg Abbott signed a law that eliminated local rules requiring water breaks for workers. Here's more on that.
Under this new law, the state will have power to override municipal code throughout Texas in certain circumstances. So any law that is stricter than state law. And currently, some cities like Dallas mandate construction workers take a 10-minute break every 4 hours. So with this new law, that mandate would disappear. Opponents say this takes away the city's or town's right to protect its workers. Critics are calling it, quote, the Death Star bill. That's a Star Wars reference. But first, you're going to hear from a supporter who says small businesses who don't have the staff to keep track of all the different laws and regulations across different cities, this say it will make things easier. It will cut down on confusion and make things more consistent across the state when it comes to labor and other regulations.
So I want to note that this new change will go into effect on September 1st in Texas. But what I'm about to tell you is kind of symbolic, well, not symbolic, it actually happened, but you should expect a lot more of this considering the weakening of labor protection in the state of Texas. So shortly after that law passed, a 35-year-old utility lineman in Marshall, Texas, died after experiencing heat illness symptoms. We live in the United States of America, one of the richest countries in the world, where corporate profits year after year increase, and where ordinary people see their wages stagnate, see their working conditions deteriorate. Now, luckily, because of some leverage that workers have, wages have gone up a little bit. But the fact that we can't have safe working conditions in the United States of America tells you everything you need to know about the imbalance of power we have in our democratic system, where again, the whims and the desires of corporate interests outweigh the concerns of ordinary Americans and the very workers who make things happen in this country, who keep things running in this country, who produce the food you eat, okay, who make the products you buy, who provide the services you need. These are the people who get screwed day in, day out. And you should know, very likely you're an American worker. But with that said, the law will now revert to OSHA regulations, which I just told you that the OSHA regulations are too weak, which is why the Biden administration wanted to upgrade them to ensure that there were rules in place to protect workers during these terrible heat waves. Now, hundreds of American workers have died in recent years as a result of extreme heat on the job. I think it's important to take a step back and look at the broader picture here, because it's not just a few stories here and there. It's not just a few lives lost here and there. Since 2011, there have been 436 work-related deaths caused by environmental heat exposure, according to the US Bureau of Labor Statistics. According to UPS company records obtained by the Washington Post, at least 143 UPS employees were hospitalized for heat or dehydration-related injuries between 2015 and 2022. Now, luckily, with this new contract that the labor union signed on behalf of the UPS workers, will provide additional protections and air conditioning to prevent these types of deaths from occurring in the future. But if you're not unionized, if you don't have an organized workplace and you have no leverage, who's gonna protect you? Who's gonna look out for you? Is it gonna be the federal government? Honestly, at this point, I would say unlikely. So please talk to your workers if you can. Consider unionizing your workplace, because it could literally be a life or death situation if you don't. This is insane. The fact that we've had hundreds of workers die as a result of heat, as a result of dehydration, not having the basics to protect them, is absolutely ludicrous and disgusting.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.